Hello and welcome to this video demonstration showing how the integration between the Agilent Advanced Design System and the Cadence Allegro PCB design environment can shorten design cycles and improve design quality for RF mixed signal designs. In this video, you will hear Dan Evers of Agilent showing the design flow from an RF perspective and Gary Hind of Cadence from a PCB design perspective. You will see how easy it is to keep the parts library synchronized between the two design environments, thus enabling the transfer of complete designs that include packaged parts.
For the third demonstration, we're actually going to show library export management of libraries and synchronization of libraries between the Cadence environment and the ADS environment. First thing I'm going to do here is I'll select the design project. I actually have some libraries loaded here. The library I've got loaded is, one of the libraries I've got loaded is a library called Preferred. This is the library that I'm going to be accessing for components that I would like to transfer and make available to the RF engineer before we start the design. So I'll select OK here. We'll use the tools and we'll go to RFPCB and we'll select the Allegro Discrete Library to Agilent ADS Translator. This will read my project file and actually give me access to the libraries that we've just reviewed inside the project. I don't want to transfer everything here. I want to be very specific. And there are some resistors inside the design that I would like to transfer. What I can do is either select individual resistors or grab whole numbers of resistors, take them and either select them for translation or actually remove them for remove them from the translation as well. So in this instance here, you can see I've now reduced this list from 80 to 40 odd. Again, I can also incrementally add more elements here, and using filtering, I can actually work down and select the parts that I would like to translate. Having selected all of the elements that I would like to transfer and make ready as elements for ADS, what I will do is save the files to a transfer area, and then I select translate, and that's it. It's that quick. It's created both schematic and footprint IFF files ready for transfer. I select close, we select done. I now am ready to take this data and pass this data to the RF engineer.
The next step in this demo process is to import the symbols and footprints exported from Cadence into ADS. These will form the basis for future designs. It really solves a problem that we commonly have, that RF engineers are not using the corporate standard schematic symbols, not using the corporate standard footprints. When an RF design is transferred into the corporate standard layout tool, then problems appear that wouldn't have appeared if libraries were synchronized in the first place. In ADS, we have a library utilities menu that allows us to import Cadence library files. We're going to load the symbols and the footprints and use the part mapping file that was also generated to associate those symbols and footprints together. We will go to the directory containing all of these files, the file containing the symbols, the file containing the footprints, and the file containing the part mapping file. And we just apply that to all of the other menu picks. So we don't have to do anything more than that. And we'll say OK to that, and our ADS project will be populated with the Cadence standard schematic symbols and the Cadence standard layout footprints. And here they appear in our project. Every symbol and part number combination appears as a new design in ADS, and every footprint appears as a standard design in ADS. Now we can open a blank schematic and test these components just to see that they're valid. Scroll down here and pick one of these and place that. And I'll pick one of these, place that. And if you probe any of these components and look at their properties, we'll see that every piece of information that Cadence had stored about this component in its library is also now available in ADS. So we know the tolerance, we know the value, we know this is a preferred or not preferred part for your company. Likewise, if we look at the parameters that ADS will use to synchronize this component with layout, we've got the Cadence JEDEC type property and the appropriate Cadence footprint to be called out for use with this part. That'll be true for the other part as well. And we can test these in our layout environment as well. I pull this schematic symbol into our layout, we get the corporate standard footprint. Same for this one. So from this point forward, these components can be used in an ADS schematic and an ADS layout with complete confidence that the symbols exactly match what's in Cadence, the footprints exactly match what's in Cadence, and that any design that is done with these parts can be transferred into Cadence and it will be a well-behaved corporate standard compliant schematic and layout. The final steps at this point would be for the corporate librarian to add valid RF simulation models to these parts, and if they're going to be used by more than one engineer on more than one project, they should then be published into an ADS design kit.
Thank you for viewing this video about the integrated solution from Agilent and Cadence. There are also three other videos covering other aspects of the design flow, including the transfer of RF circuits, the transfer of custom copper shapes, and transferring designs with packaged parts. We encourage you to watch these videos as well to get the complete picture of this integrated solution. And if you haven't experienced ADS firsthand, you can visit this URL to get a free ADS trial license.